Hello guys, welcome to another video with Cass on the Maizuma channel. Last time I showed you guys this potion lab, which is capable of brewing all the 15 different potions currently available in the game. And the cool thing about it is that it's completely automatic. Basically, you just have to pick up the potions, and if the system senses that enough potions are missing from the chest, it automatically starts brewing new potions. The lab is made out of simple machines like this, where all the ingredients are accessible from the front here, and you also have some blaze powder storage here, and it also comes with individual water bottle generators, so that basically allows you to store a bunch of glass bottles here that get converted on demand. The amount of glass bottles that go inside here, when totally full, is capable of brewing more than 10 double chests like this. So refilling shouldn't be one of your worries, but anyways, people who started building this told me that these dispensers in particular are not easily accessible from the side when you start tiling the units like this for the potion lab, which is why I changed this design a little bit. So now, also of course, it includes something that I showed you guys during the tutorial. It includes this redstone line here, which basically prevents the system from producing more water bottles than necessary. Now I included this hopper line here, marked with the blue carpet here. So from above, from the top, you can use a minecart or hoppers or whatever. And then you can place water bottles, glass bottles inside these dispensers. And these dispensers become reachable through this hopper line. I also designed this separate device, which is a smart water bottle filler. So basically you put all your glass bottles in here, and they're going to be converted into water bottles on demand. And then you can hook this chest here up to a hopper line or use a minecart system. So for example, if I get rid of this minecart here by breaking it and pick up the bottles, if I place another minecart here, it's going to start pulling bottles from here, and then the system is going to automatically activate it and open the trapdoor to see you guys. So yeah, and the system is going to produce water bottles at the exact quantity so that it can fill up whatever it needs to fill up, and also will fill up the chest again, and then it's going to stop. See, not working anymore, and no water bottles are wasted. And the logic behind it is also interesting, because it senses the chest to make sure that we always have water bottles in here, but it also takes into account the number of glass bottles that we have in here. So if there are no glass bottles to run the system, then the system's not going to run anyways. And here you can see how I adapted the centralized water distribution system to the previous lab. So yeah, I took a few potions from these units here, so the system's currently brewing some of those, as you can see here. And what happens now is I removed basically the water generators from every one of those guys in here. So yeah, I basically simplified the circuit because we don't have these two layers here above this line. Also a little bit of the redstone that goes inside here. Got rid of all of this, and then I replaced it. And as you can see, it's already working. But minecarts are fully loaded with water bottles. And as you can see, if possibly, you can see that I have more than one minecart there. And that's because when the brewing stands are done, they are going to consume three potions at a time. And in the worst case, which is basically theoretical, it's never going to happen, we're going to have all the 15 stations requiring potions all at the same time, which is 15 times 3, 45, and we can't unfortunately have all 45 water bottles inside one single chest minecart. And even if we use two, it's not enough with 54, because it's going to drop the water bottles on its way going and also on its way back. So yeah, I added a third minecart just in case, but also for a different reason. And that's because everything happens in parallel. You see, it just got two pulses in here. It only pulses when these guys go without potions. So just in case, you know, it doesn't have enough time to recharge with the potions, like it's probably happening now. So if the system keeps calling the minecart, it's not going to have enough time to load with more potions. So yeah, in this case, I added the third minecart, and this is probably going to solve all the problems in here. System is not very hard to build. You can see here is where it loads the water bottles as well as the blaze powders. I need to talk about the blaze powder as well to you guys in a minute. So what it basically did is there's this buffer here, and the way I load this buffer is kind of interesting. So I just added this double chest here, and the hoppers go like this. So there are two hoppers like this and a third one like this for every unit. Since they are three wide, this works perfectly, because when the minecart goes on top of those, it's going to drop exactly three water bottles inside this on its way on its way back, three more. So this is basically perfect. It makes it so the system doesn't have to call the minecart all the time, only when this specific hopper runs out of bottles. If I take this bottle now, since I made this thing, it's going to call the minecart now because it's empty. Something changed, see? So now it has one bottle because the other ones also didn't have enough bottles. And when the minecart comes back, it's going to have two bottles. So there's a little bit of a buffer here until the system requires a minecart once again. So about the blaze powder, we have one stack of blaze powder inside the brewing stand itself, and another one here acting as a item filter. And then you can add as much as you want here inside this dropper, because it's going to be powered by this torch every time the brewing stand's done with a batch. According to the wiki, a single piece of blaze powder is capable of brewing 20 operations. So this is 20 times 3 potions, right? 60 potions. A double chest fits 54. So a single blaze powder is capable of brewing more than a double chest by itself. So by having two stacks inside this guy and zero blaze powder in here to refill it, you're already capable of filling or brewing more than 140 double chests worth of potions for each unit in here. That's it. And to give you a visual perspective on it, this is how much 140 double chests look like. So this can be done with only two stacks of blaze powder, which is also one stack of blaze rods. And this is done by a single one of these machines in here. So unless it's a really, really big exception, you don't need more than two stacks inside this system. And if you do, well, here are nine more of those. I have already mentioned this during the tutorial, but you guys can basically just place a hopper in here and have another rail line running here to distribute nether wart, because the top dropper is always going to be nether wart, with this one exception for the weakness potions, because those require this fermented spider eye to be in the first slot instead of the nether wart guys. So yeah, I won't be doing a tutorial for this, but this map contains all the components, the generator by itself here, as well as it integrated to the full lab thing. So yeah, if you guys have any questions, leave those in the comments. The map download is going to be available on my Discord server, which I would love for you guys to join. So yeah, hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and hope that this project is useful for you guys. So maybe leave a like. Thank you very much for watching, and see you soon, guys. Goodbye.